Welcome to Toulouse and welcome to our 2025 Airbus Summit.
Hi everyone. It's been an incredible couple of days here at the Airbus Summit in Toulouse. Whether you were here in person with us or joining us online, we had some very interesting progress displayed and showcased, but most importantly, we had some crucial discussions. Let's dive into the 10 key highlights you should not have missed from the summit. Highlight number one, staying firm on the course to decarbonization. It was very clear from the start, Airbus is doubling down on its effort to reach the net zero emissions by 2050 for the industry. No if, no but. Despite all the global uncertainties, Airbus is staying focused on making sustainable flight a reality. How refreshing is it to hear this kind of message? This confirmation is as vital as ever. Highlight number two, partnering with the Solar Impulse Foundation. On day one, it was announced that the Airbus Foundation is teaming up with Bertrand Piccard and the Solar Impulse Foundation for a call for project that will be launched in April for nature-based solutions that have been worked by NGOs around the world. The idea is to combine the technology from Airbus and the expertise and advocacy from the Solar Impulse Foundation to find powerful synergies. Highlight number three, SAF, Sustainable Aviation Fuel. As you understood it, it's part of all conversation and it's a key enabler to decarbonize aviation. However, the production is too slow, too little. So we need to heavily scale up production of SAF. For that, we need regulators to find the right balance between incentives to boost the supply, like tax credits or revenue certainty mechanism, and mandates to encourage the demand from airlines, but also encourage the high integrity fuels. Which leads to another issue, which is the accessibility of SAF. That's highlight number four. To help bridge the gap in SAF availability, Airbus announced a book and claim demonstrator in partnership with RSB. The idea is for an airline to be able to credit and take benefit of a SAF which has been used in another part of the world. That prevents the logistical constraints regarding transporting SAF all around the world. It will also bring benefits of SAF productions to all corners of the world, including the developing countries. Number five, it's not just about CO2. We talked also about non-CO2 emissions and in particular contrails, which by the science is having an order of magnitude in terms of impact similar to the CO2 aviation emissions. Airbus is playing a leading role on that topic with many research projects like Ciconia to study flight path optimization, but also Pacific to investigate different kind of fuel and different kind of engines on minimizing the contrails formation. We are really at a tipping point between fine-tuning the research and initiate the operational framework. For that, we're taking a holistic approach that brings airlines, manufacturers, and air traffic control to really prepare for concrete actions. And number six is my personal highlight of the summit, the sneak peek at the next generation single aisle, and it's looking slick. Clean sheet design, longer, slender, foldable wings, new propulsion technologies like the ultra-high bypass ratio engines or the revolutionary open fan, more connected and automated systems, 20 to 30% jump in fuel efficiency, and it will fly on 100% SAF. Still some mystery on the launch date, but I'm hoping for sooner rather than later. Highlight seven, the long game. The dream of flying without emitting any CO2 thanks to hydrogen is still very much alive. We provided an update on the ZeroE project, now focusing on fuel cell and distribution technologies and a very cool looking four-pod design. It might take a bit longer than initially hoped, but there is some tangible progress. If we reach the right level of maturity and if the ecosystem of hydrogen comes along, it might be an ultimate game changer in the long term. Number eight, carbon removals. While avoiding and reducing emissions remains the priority, the summit also addressed the critical role of carbon removals, whether as nature-based solutions or technology-based solutions like direct air capture. While not a silver bullet to continue business as usual, the carbon removal technologies will play a critical role in addressing the residual emissions, in particular for hard-to-abate sectors like aviation. It's all part of a comprehensive strategy. We need to invest now to get the development going and get the cost down. Highlight number 9, the Racer demonstrator. Imagine combining technologies from aircraft and helicopter. Thanks to that, a European project that showcased the cooperation between 13 countries managed to reach 420 kilometers for the Racer, which is twice as much as conventional helicopters, while cutting fuel consumption and emission. Imagine the impact for energy services where every second counts. Number 10, artificial intelligence. The power of AI to drive sustainability was also a key theme. Increasingly, AI is playing a vital role in aerospace, from making operations more efficient to helping with environmental monitoring, like the analysis of vast amounts of data from our Earth observation satellite. Rapid detection of wildfires, deforestation, or supporting sustainable agriculture, that's part of the use cases we can imagine with AI. This data-driven approach is very important because it provides invaluable insight in informing climate action. So there you have it, just a taste of the innovation and collaboration on display at the Airbus Summit 2025. To use again the motto of the summit, innovate, inform, inspire, the message is clear. The path to net zero requires to innovate relentlessly, to inform transparently, and to inspire collective action across the industry and beyond. So a huge thank you to all of you, students, colleagues, researchers, activists, partners, even competitors. It's a huge challenge we have in front of us, and it's going to take all of us working together. Thanks for tuning in. Let us know in the comments what highlights you are most excited about. Make sure to stay connected with the next updates. And in the meantime, safe travels.